What is CAS? The SAS Cloud Analytic Services, or CAS, is a server that provides the environment for data management and analytics with SAS Viya. Suitable for both on-premises and cloud deployments, CAS uses a combination of hardware and software where data management and analytics take place on either a single machine or as a distributed server across multiple machines. We want to scale CAS, and to do that, it helps to understand the flexibility that Viya provides in deployment. Starting with the Viya platform itself, it's possible to install everything all together on one host. While this is simple, it doesn't provide enterprise-level functionality in demand today. So we can choose to deploy Viya across multiple hosts if we want to. Further, we can split out resource-intensive Viya components, like the in-memory analytics provided by SAS Cloud Analytic Services. Notice that by splitting software roles to different machines allows us to optimize those hosts for their respective workloads, and having the ability to add more hosts allows us to improve availability of software services by eliminating single points of failure and also gives SAS Viya the ability to handle more work. CAS can operate in two kinds of modes. One, shown here as SMP, is when CAS runs on a single host like most software. Scalability in this mode, however, is limited to the ultimate size of the host machine. Way more interesting is when CAS can run as a single service, which is deployed across multiple hosts. This mode is referred to as MPP for massively parallel processing, and the CAS service implements two roles. One is the CAS controller, which accepts and answers incoming requests for analytics and data processing, and two, several CAS workers, which use a shared nothing approach where data is distributed across the hosts such that each worker only processes a small portion of the larger request, each operating in parallel to the others. It's this idea, where CAS can be scaled up to handle larger workloads by adding more worker hosts, that we focus on from here. A lot of considerations must be addressed when deploying and updating a Viya environment. If you're already experienced with Viya deployments, then the process to scale out CAS workers to more host machines will be straightforward to understand. And before making substantial changes to your Viya deployment, it's a smart idea to ensure you've got a recent full system backup just in case things go awry. So, the number one task for scaling out CAS workers is to provision the hardware and perform the necessary prerequisites and pre-installation tasks. If using virtual machines to host Viya, then most of that work can be performed once and the image saved for subsequent reuse. The second task is to locate your site's Ansible controller host and modify the SAS Viya playbook which was used to deploy this software. Specifically, we need to edit the inventory file to identify the new host machines and direct Ansible to place the Viya software for CAS there. The third item is to run the deployment play using the deploy-casworker.yml file. This runs an abbreviated process where the CAS software is placed on the new hosts and initial integration with the rest of Viya is configured. With the software installed, the next step is to direct CAS to add the new worker to its cluster. We can accomplish this in SAS Environment Manager as a user with the necessary administrative privileges. And finally, we can validate that Viya continues to operate uninterrupted in general, and specifically to test that the CAS workers are participating as intended on the new hosts. Staging the new host machines for CAS workers and ensuring they meet Viya's system requirements is an important step. For details on what this means, visit the support.sas.com website and refer to the documentation provided by SAS Viya 3.5 for Linux Deployment Guide, jumping to the section about how deployment works, and look for the reference to the SAS Viya Administration Resource Kit, what we call the Viya ARC. The Viya ARC provides automation to address most of the pre-installation tasks needed to ready a machine for Viya software. And the direct link to the Viya ARC is included here. As you can see, it's an open source project hosted in GitHub, which is maintained by SAS for our customers to use. The inventory file is used to direct Ansible how to deploy the Viya software to the various machines in the environment. The first lines at the top of the inventory file describe the deploy targets using host aliases. A host alias is simply a nickname which is associated with a machine's fully qualified domain name or other identifier. In this simple example, we have three host machines, each with a unique nickname that I've chosen corresponding to their roles in the deployment. Notice that the alias doesn't need to match anything in the machine's actual host name. We use these aliases in the next section of the inventory file to associate software components, listed here in square brackets and referred to as host groups. A host group usually refers to several different discrete software components that SAS has grouped together to ensure proper operation. For CAS, there are actually three different host groups which contain its software. SAS CAS Server Primary contains the main CAS controller software. And if this is the only host group populated with a deploy target in the inventory file, then it specifies an SMP single machine deployment of CAS. SAS CAS Server Secondary contains the secondary CAS controller software. While useful for high availability deployments of CAS, its use is optional and not in scope for our discussion here, so we will leave it unpopulated. And finally, there's the SAS CAS Server Worker host group, which we use to deploy the workers of an MPP CAS deployment. As a rule, we should always specify different deploy targets for each CAS host group. Do not specify the same host alias to act as a CAS controller and also as a CAS worker, nor should you list the same host alias multiple times under any host group. CAS scalability is all about serious high performance, and so we need hosts dedicated to these roles to achieve that. Also note that while an MPP CAS deployment technically has no minimum number of required workers, it's inefficient just having one. But in this video, to keep the examples easy to grasp, my environment is shown with just one worker. But let's all agree that it's not a recommendation for your production deployments, okay? Okay. In the lower right corner, you can see we've added a second host machine as a CAS worker. We add a new deployment target at the top of the inventory file with a unique host alias to represent the new machine we want to add. Then we insert the new deploy target's host alias under the SAS CAS Server Worker host group to direct Ansible to install the necessary Viya software to that machine. The deploy-casworker.yml play file contains the instructions that Ansible will follow to install SAS Viya software for the CAS worker. So after editing the inventory file, we're ready for Ansible to install the software on the new host by calling the Ansible playbook command and specifying deploy-casworker.yml as the input file. Running the deploy-casworker play will produce a lot of text output as Ansible performs the installation on the new CAS worker host. This won't interrupt any current Viya processes or user activity. After the new software has been installed, then we move on to perform the manual steps which will make this new CAS worker active. With the CAS worker software installed on the new host, we can now notify CAS about the new worker at a convenient time. Navigating the interface for this task is a little tricky, so I'll show more detail here. Let's get started by logging on to SAS Environment Manager as administrative user. Navigating to the Servers pane, you'll find the icon for this labeled as Servers in the left-hand navigation. In my environment, it's the third from the top. Don't confuse it with the Machines icon further down, which serves a different purpose. For most Viya sites, you should expect one CAS server named similar to CAS shared default. However, if your site has multiple CAS servers, click to select the one you're adding the new workers to. Then click the icon to assume an additional privilege, the super user role. And now we can click the icon for configuration and modify this CAS server. When editing the CAS server, there are three tabs to choose from. Select the Nodes tab to see a list of host machines for this CAS server and their roles. To modify the CAS server, first click on any of the listed nodes, then click the Edit icon. In the Edit Nodes dialog, click the Add Nodes icon and enter the fully qualified domain name for the new CAS worker host. This is an example for just adding one, but you can add several additional CAS workers by repeating this step as needed. With the modification complete, click Save to close this dialog and then relinquish the superuser role just to be safe. Validation of significant changes to the system is always an important step. Test that your Viya deployment is functioning correctly and confirm that the new CAS worker participates in user CAS sessions. Once you're happy the system looks good, you can enjoy the additional processing power that the new CAS workers bring to your system. Now we move to the demonstration part of this video, where I can quickly show how simple it is to add a new CAS worker host to my existing Viya deployment. So let's take a look at my environment here. First thing I want to do is log in to SAS Studio as an administrative user. And now that I'm in Studio, all I need to do is start a new SAS program. What I want to do is show you that I can start a CAS session from here. And when SAS Studio connects to that CAS session, it tells me how many CAS workers are participating. In this case, I just have one because I have this small sample test environment to show you guys. So here I want to log on to my Ansible controller host in the environment, and I need to be logging in as the deployment user account. In this case, I'm logged in as cloud user on a machine called Int Viya01. And this is the machine that hosts my SAS Viya playbook. So by switching into that directory, there's a whole list of files in here, and we can edit the inventory.ini file. Yours might have a different name, that's what mine's called. And at the top of this file, you can see the list of deploy targets that are defined for this environment. We have five right now, and they represent a list of machines that already have the Viya software installed. So we're just updating an existing environment to add another CAS worker. The way to do that is I need to add a sixth line here with a new host alias. I'm going to call it SAS CAS03. You really could call it anything that you want. It does not have to match, other than just keeping things easy for your administrators to understand. Then we tell Ansible the name of the host machine that we're going to be adding. And in this case, mine is going to be called intcas03.race.sas.com. Now, that defines the machine to Ansible, but we haven't told Ansible what software we want there. And that's where we need to scroll down in the inventory file. We need to find our SAS CAS server host group. And you can see right now, I just have one CAS worker defined. It's on SAS CAS 02. That's probably not typical for any production MPP deployment of CAS, but we're just using a small example environment here, right? So I want to add a second CAS worker, and I'm going to specify that new host alias that we just defined at the top of the file. Now, this is the only change I need to make to the inventory file at this time. We're just adding the one worker, and so I save that and we're done. Next step then is to actually run the Ansible playbook that will deploy the CAS worker software onto that new machine. And we do that by using the Ansible playbook command, of course, Ansible playbook, and we tell it which playbook we want it to run. And SAS provides a specific playbook just for this use case. It's called deploy-casworker.yml. And all this guy does is install the necessary software on the host that we have identified, and that's it. So we can go ahead and kick that off and run it. Okay, so the playbook has finished running. It only took about 13 or 14 minutes in my environment to get this done because all we did was add new software to a single host and did not interrupt any of the other operations for Viya that are currently running. Having a successful playbook run like this is great, but it's always a good idea to go and validate that the rest of the environment is working like we expect. So let's go over to our web browser and go check on things in SAS Environment Manager. When SAS Environment Manager first loads, it brings up the dashboard. And on the left side of the dashboard, we see a bunch of green squares. And listed for the machines, we now can see that there are six green squares. One of these is our new CAS worker host, intcas03. So the Viya software is installed there, and Viya is aware of that machine. However, on the right side, we see a bar chart that shows the status of our current CAS server. And you can see there's two nodes. There's int CAS01, which is our controller, and there's int CAS02, which is the one worker. However, where's the second worker? We just added it, right? Well, we haven't actually told CAS that it has a second worker it can use yet, and that's what we have to do at this point. What we need to do then is navigate to the server's location. So on the left side here, it's about the third icon from the top, and when you mouse over it, it should say the word servers, and then that will take us to the list of server services in the environment. The first one is CAS. The default CAS deployment is called CAS Shared Default. Now, we need to make a special change to add a worker. And even though we have administrative privileges in this environment, well, that's not quite enough. We need to click this icon so that we can assume the super user role. With the super user role in place, now it's a good idea to click on the wrench for configuration so we can make changes to CAS Shared Default. Now that we're in here to make changes, it tells us a list of active sessions and the CAS configuration status. But what we're interested in are the nodes or the machines that are going to be hosting CAS. And as you can see, CAS is currently aware that it has two nodes. They've got CAS01 and CAS02. But you'll see our CAS03 host has not yet appeared. So what we can do is click on any one of these to activate the pencil icon so that we can edit this CAS server configuration. With that, it brings up the Edit Nodes dialog, and we want to add a node, so all we have to do is click the plus sign, and it will prompt us to give the new CAS name. So we provide the fully qualified domain name as we define in the environment. And that's all we need to do. CAS will find it from there, so we just click Save. And it has, says it's successfully added the saved nodes. And if we click Refresh, then you can see it's found, and it's got the correct IP address, and everything looks great. So just to be safe, let's go ahead and relinquish our super user role so we don't accidentally do anything else we don't want to. And so with this in place, we can now go over and confirm that this new worker is doing what we expect. So let's go back over into SAS Studio, and I still have my program code up from last time. And we remember we started a CAS session. Well, that CAS session is still running. It's still active in the environment. So any existing users, they haven't noticed that you've been making changes. We can go ahead and start a second CAS session, however, and I submit that code. And now it tells us that this session is using two workers. So I have two CAS sessions now. I've got a session called one and a session called two. And those names happen to correspond to the number of workers that they're each running. But this basically validates that CAS is able to use the new worker. And so we've successfully added it to the system and everything is looking great. So the validation is complete for our demonstration. Thank you for watching. Be sure to look at the recommended resources listed below this video for more information about this topic, including what you might want to do for data that was already loaded into CAS before you added the new workers. And enjoy using SAS Viya 3.5.